Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. In this video, we're going to make a chair. A very handy camp chair that weighs less than 2 ounces. Stay with me. And this is what it looks like all folded up. Very lightweight, very compact. Let's go put it together. All right, we'll lay this out so you hopefully can kind of get an idea on how it all goes together. So, okay, this is the pattern that I made, and I'll show you how to make your pattern. Okay, I put 2 pieces of freezer paper, meat wrapping paper, together here. It was about so long and about so wide. Now, you're going to have to come up with some source of material to use as a pattern. Okay, let's get started. Now, what we do is we'll make a flat line 22 1/4 inches long on our paper. And keep in mind that it has to be far enough in from the edge of the paper to allow for this here. Okay, and I'll explain what that is and how it all works later. But after you make your straight line at 22 1/4 inches, you'll have to find halfway, which is 11 1/8. Take a straight line with that has a right angle edge to it, so that you can, so that it's not gonna, so that the line will be straight. And then put it right on your 11 1/8 inch mark and make a line, clear up. Now, that will give you the center point that we're looking for. Now, go out to the edge. Put your straight line on the edge of your triangle, of your 22 1/4 inch line. Swing this around until it intersects that line. Now disregard this center triangle. I had to use that to come up with this final measurement, but you don't need that. Okay, just consider that this line goes straight on up here. You swing this until it meets that line. Make a line. Do the same on the other side. Put this on the point of the 22 1/4 inch line here. Swing this over until it intersects your line, and then make your vertical line here, and then make a line. So now you've got your triangle to work with. So now we've got our basic triangle. Now what we need to do is come up with this. These are going to be the flaps here, the pockets for your sticks. Okay, so how we come up with that is we measure from the point of the triangle 4 inches. 4 inches should be fine. Down the side of the triangle, make a mark. Do the same on the other side of the triangle. And make a mark. Then make a straight line across. Do that on all 3 corners. Now, how you come up with this line here is you're going to have to fold your paper over on the line that you just made. And in this case, this being white paper, I was able to see my line that I'd wrote the edge of the triangle here. I was able to transfer that onto this piece of paper here, and then I could cut it off. Same here and same on all the other sides. Something you may have to do if you can't see through your paper, if you're using like a brown paper sack, say, taped together, you might have to take a pin and poke a hole through your paper right here and right here. That will tell you where to bend your paper, okay? And then you've now got this as a reference point, and you can see your line here. This paper would be sticking on out here somewhere, and you can see this line, use this as a straight edge to mark your line. So that's our pattern, and now you can see how it goes together. These are the pockets. Okay, now what I did was I folded over the edge of the pocket, folded it to the inside like that, and sewed it on the sewing machine. Just sewed a seam across there and then cut off these edges here. I did that on all four of these. Okay, or three of these, excuse me. Okay, after I folded these over, I sewed this here and stopped. Sewed it here, stopped. Did that on all three of these. Okay, then I folded this over. It's kind of hard to do on this paper, but I folded it over and hemmed it again. And sewed that. Once that's done, this edge is completely done now. Do the same on all three sides and you've got your finished chair. I forgot to say earlier that this is a heavy-duty nylon, real thick, heavy-duty nylon. I believe it's a Cordura. Now, one thing that makes this chair so light is that you cut your legs out in the field. So, I cut the leg about from my armpit to about the middle of my palm, and I rounded off the top. That's to make it, hopefully you can see that, how I rounded that off. That is to make it so it goes in the pocket and doesn't damage the chair at all. Now for the legs, you use a standard tripod lashing technique. Now I'm not going to go into how to do that in this video. If you're not familiar with how to do a tripod lashing, then take a look at this video here. Now, when you do the lashing, you want to, on one stick where you start your lashing, start approximately a third of the way up the stick from the bottom, okay, and make the middle stick just a little bit higher than that, maybe quarter of an inch higher, and then make the far stick, the third stick, about an inch higher. Hopefully you can see that. Okay. Now, how you set it up is you pull the middle stick towards you, the top, and pull the far stick towards you. And that's the way it'll set up, just like that. Let's go ahead and put the chair on and see if we need to make any adjustments. That's looking pretty good, actually, right there. Yep, all the legs seem to be pretty even. Now, if you put it together and you see that one leg is higher than the other, then you can, adjust that leg up or down, tweak it until you have it where you want it. And then if you have a problem with the legs slipping, okay, that looks pretty good. maybe go down a little bit with this one. Okay, that looks good right there. All right, if you have a problem with your legs slipping, what you could do is make a mark where the string crosses on the outside of each one of these sticks, and then take a knife and make a groove right there where those sticks cross, and then relash so that your strings go into the groove, and then it should be pretty stable. So let's try it out. Now, how much weight will this hold? Well, that is really something that I cannot answer. I weigh about 160 pounds roughly with all my clothes on as I'm sitting here like this. And, you know, it holds me just fine. Will it hold you? I can't answer that. It has a lot to do with your sewing job, you know, how well you sew. You'll want to use a polyester thread on this. You know, that way it'll stand up to the outdoors, you know, won't rot when it gets wet, whatnot. And as far as how much weight it'll hold, that also depends on the quality of the nylon that you buy. As you can see, this works well for me. Now, I like a tripod chair in the outdoors because with three legs, you've always got all three legs equally on the ground. In a quad leg chair, a four leg chair, on uneven ground, you might have one leg that doesn't want to be on the ground because of the unevenness. Okay, so I'm glad you joined me for this, and I really enjoyed sharing it with you. I hope you enjoyed watching. We'll see you guys on the next video. You take care.